Okay, so this is what we have for trig 10. In the diagram, the angle between two forces, OP and OQ. So you can just imagine, because in this kind of questions, right, as well as your physics, it is always useful for you to visualize what is happening. So there is an object at O. There are two forces pulling it, one in the direction of OP with 15 newtons, another force, OQ, pulling it in another direction with 12 newtons. Now use your common sense. When you have a force 15 newtons to the right, a force 12 newtons in this direction, what do you think the resultant is going to look like? Just imagine, okay, two people pulling you, one this way, one person pulling stronger, the other pulling not as strong. So what is the resultant going to look like? What way are you going to be traveling? Diagonally, right? This force is going to contribute a motion to the right. This force is going to contribute a motion to the top left. But this one is stronger. So this force over here, the top left one, actually can be broken down into two parts. Let me show you. This force, OQ, can be broken down into a force upwards and another force to the left. Okay, a blue one and a red one. Red one is pointing upwards, blue is pointing to the left. If we consider only the vertical forces up and down, in this whole diagram, how many forces up and down do we have? You look at this 12, it's not broken down into red and plus blue. So the 12 doesn't exist anymore. Out of the remaining three forces, one over here, one here, one here. How many forces in the y-axis direction do you have? One. Okay, what is the direction? Up or down? Up, right? So the magnitude is this one. That is why your resultant also has the same magnitude upwards. Okay? That's another way of looking at it. Now in the left-right direction, how many forces do you see? Two, right? We've got a blue one, which is quite tiny, and 15, which is a few times greater than it. So which one is going to win? 15 or the blue one? Obviously 15, so it is going to move to the right. So the resultant is actually going to be up this red one plus 15 minus the blue one, which is, this is the remainder. Okay, so this is our resultant force. That is what is happening for maths and physics for vectors. No matter your vector is displacement, force, velocity, acceleration, any type of vectors, quantities, we can use this idea. So, in summary, just now I broke down this 12 newtons into a vertical and a horizontal force. We can actually use our parallelogram law, which is what was used over here. Just draw a parallelogram from the start, which is O, to the diagonally across to the other part of the parallelogram. That will be our resultant vector. So the other way of looking at it is that we take OQ, we move it over here. So it becomes OP plus P, whatever this point is, move the vector over. So effectively, we are traveling from O to this diagonal to the point over there. Okay? So now we want to calculate the magnitude of the resultant force. So this is the one that I want to calculate. Magnitude being the size. Okay, in this case, we are going to use the magnitudes. This is 15, this is 12, so this must also be 12. And I join up, I draw my triangle myself, or parallelogram, whichever you like, you will result in this resultant force. And using what we have used yesterday in example 10, we can find this angle over here because what is the relationship between 115 and 65 degrees? What straight line? 115 and 65. No. They add up to be 180 degrees. What is that property called? Remember, this is a parallelogram. No. No.
Triangle.
Hey, y'all forget all your... And I hope you remember included angle. So I said before, as long as you are given for a triangle, if you are given one side, let's say this is given, and the included angle is given, straight away you must be using your cosine rule. Okay? Because our cosine rule says that A square equals to B square plus C square minus 2BC cosine angle A. Okay? So over here I see the side, side, side. These two sides are repeated and an angle. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 items. As long as you provide me with any of these three, I can find the fourth one. You give me three sides, I will use cosine rule. You give me two sides plus included angle, I will use cosine rule. That's how it works. Which is what is happening in this case. So using our cosine rule, we can find the magnitude of the resultant force, over here the longest line, to be 14.7 newtons. Then you must ask yourself, does the number make sense or not? If this is 15, this is 12, do you expect this to be larger or smaller than 15? You cannot tell, right? But roughly can estimate or not. It looks like it should be close to 15, right? Looking at this scale drawing, right? If you, for some reason, get 30 newtons, does it make sense? Okay, if it is not drawn on scale, 30 newtons is possible. Really? If this is 15, then this is, I want the resultant to be very big. Naturally, I have to put it over here. This is 12. Can my resultant ever be 30? Cannot be. My maximum is going to be 27, and that is not even a triangle. That is a straight line. So you get a value that is greater than 27, then it doesn't make sense really. Okay? So need to use common sense. Okay, we've done addition already, now subtraction. I'm gonna go really quickly because it's just kind of the opposite of addition, which is how we always learn subtraction. So u minus v is the same as u plus negative v. Easy? It's really common sense, right? Okay, then now you need to tell me what exactly does V over here and negative V mean to you. Suppose I've got this vector called V. Can you draw negative V for me? Are you able to do it? Opposite, right? With the same magnitude, right? So this is negative V lah. Okay? So when I ask you to take, for example, u minus v, so this is u, then I want you to minus v. V is given over here already. What I will do is I will draw a negative, okay, let me use another color. I will draw this. In red, this is negative v. Do you agree? All agree?
Yeah.
Negative v, yeah? Then I'm going to cut it out. And I'm going to put it at the end of u. Right? So now I've got u plus a negative v. Do you agree? Sophia, okay? Okay, one more time. Let me just put it aside first. Now this is, here I've got u over here. Starting from a, ending at b. Right? If I ask you to plus v, what will you do? If it is a question of u plus v, what will you do? Up and right, right? Because that is what v looks like. So v is over here. This is v. I'm just copying it only. Then our... Oh. Try again. So put it over here. So this becomes u plus v, right? Okay, u plus v, starting at a, ending at this point. So in blue over here, this is called u plus v. Agree? Okay, now something is different. The question doesn't want u plus v. It wants u minus v. Okay? So, since V looks like this, then I know that negative V is just the Same vector, but in the opposite direction, right? This is negative V, right? Okay, so again, U plus this negative V. Isn't this what it looks like? Okay, so U minus V looks like this. We are starting, still starting at A, but now where's our ending point? After I go U plus a negative V, this is my new ending point, right? Okay, so this being U, this being negative V, my resultant force looks like this, the black one. Okay, and this resultant force is called U minus V lah. Can? All okay? Shufi okay? Silin? Can you understand? Which part don't understand? Are you following? Which part don't you understand? And you better not tell me you don't understand anything. Vector U minus vector V, we can write it in terms of the letters, the points for the different vectors. So U, Celine, what is the vector for U? In terms of A, B, C, D, A, B, C, E, what is another name for vector U? AB, yeah, okay, U is simply AB. So write down AB. Okay, we are supposed to now subtract vector V. Mustalifa, what is the name, another name for vector V? AC, okay, AB minus AC. Then I've also gone through this exercise with you. XY is the same as negative. Harif? Negative what? XY is the same as negative? YX, okay. So here I've got negative AC, right? What? Oh, sorry, YX. Okay, so if I have negative AC, this is gonna be equal to positive what? CA lah. Can you see I'm just switching the place and then I remove the negative sign? Okay, so here we're gonna do that. Negative AC is the same as CA. So I've got AB plus CA. Okay. AB plus CA. Is it the same as CA plus AB? Are they the same? AB plus CA, CA plus AB, are they the same thing? Jolene, are they the same? AB plus CA and CA plus AB.
Yes.
Ah, they are the same, right? Then what do we notice about CA plus AB? Yeah, the center is AA, right? Common, right? So I can cancel them. So I'm left with? I don't want to say. Okay? It's very unfortunate that the textbook has this. So in summary, our answer for U minus V. U minus V, we say that it is actually this vector over here, right? This is U minus V. Can you spot another vector that is exactly the same as the one in black? Yes, what is it called? What is the same vector as this, U minus V? One more time? Yeah, you're right. So this is the one lah, U minus V, okay? Every year we talk about this. You're just waiting for this to come out. Okay, next. So let's link this back to matrices. So easy. U minus V is the same as, let's say U is X1, Y1, V is X2, Y2. So we don't even want to do this. X1, Y1 minus X2, Y2 equals to X1 minus X2, Y1 minus Y2. Simple, huh? Okay, time to do some drawing. There isn't going to be much space, but I'll just demonstrate the first one for you. I've got vector u and vector v as shown in part A. Okay? Now I want vector u minus v. So I'll just trace out my u, which is over here. Vector u starting from here. This is vector u, right? Now I want to minus v. What direction do you think I should go? What does v look like? V is going up, right? So negative v must be going downwards, lah. Okay. Down by how many units?
Two.
2 units. So do I continue from here? Since my u start here,
yes.
Then I ended here, right? So I go down 2 units, lah.
Negative v.
So this one is called negative v. Label it. Okay.